Let's discuss the issue further and welcome on to the program Naftali Bennett, former Israeli defense minister and current prime ministerial candidate. You are welcome to the program, sir. Why has Israel been so reticent about the courts and a potential probe?
Well, because this is a perversion of justice, of any basic morals. You know, when one side attacks another, the second side has a right of self-defense. Let me tell you something amazing. On June 12th, 2014, Hamas kidnapped three young Israeli boys and murdered them. On June 13th, Israel began to retaliate. So the ICC decided to start the investigation the day of the retaliation, but forgot to investigate the day of the kidnap. That's sort of like being mugged on the street and then the police only investigating the person who was mugged and is fighting back. This is a profound distortion of any form of justice. It's a sham, and we're not going to, give up or tie our hands while defending ourselves.
If Israel has done nothing wrong, or at least in comparison to what Palestinian militants have done, then surely you should welcome a probe into something that's going to make and put to light what you believe Israel has not done wrong, and that could go now to a global audience.
No, because the court is not a court. It's, they call it the ICC. I view it the International Circus of Clowns. These folks have no basic premise of right and wrong. There's no basis for even thinking about doing this. Let me tell you something. You know, I fought in quite a few wars defending my family. Hamas shoots rockets at Israelis from within hospitals, within homes, within schools. And then when we want to fight back, then this ICC thing tells us that we're immoral. We're not going to play this game.
But Jews are no longer going to deem themselves helpless.
In the face of murderers. That's
but
not gonna happen.
You're saying that the militants were based in hospitals and schools, but by firing back were actually schools and nurses and doctors were working, civilians were killed. There's very much a sense of proportionality to be held here, isn't there? And Israel did not do that.
Is there? You know, if someone is shooting your kids from within a school, how proportional are you gonna react?
Well, there's a sense of self-defense, of course. I agree with that. But in terms of doing that, do you not prolong the war and the victims in Israel as well as Palestine, making it even worse for future generations? Surely there's a stage where you have to say, listen, we're going to go after these people, but we're not going to try to kill as many civilians as we did before.
No. You're distorting things. We never are out to kill civilians.
Absolutely. But they have been killed, haven't they?
Oh, they've been killed by their own government, Hamas, which places rockets next to their children. So
yes,
let me be very clear.
Your weapons
whoever,
them,
whoever places rockets from within civilians, he is murdering his own people, not Israel.
I'm not trying to distort it. I'm just trying to give the facts. What the UN said about Operation Protective Edge in 2014, 495 children, 253 women. Surely Israel has to take some responsibility for that.
Oh, really? Really? Let me ask you, how much responsibility did the USSR have on Nazi Germany when conquering in the Second World War? There's an evil side that is attacking. There's a good side that's defending. And the only side that holds any responsibility is the offender. Let me be very clear. You know, if there's a list of people who are going to The Hague, I'm going to be at the top of the list. We will never tie the hands of an Israeli soldier while defending itself. You know, she called it a cycle of violence. That's like calling 9/11 a cycle of violence. There's no violence there. That's a terror attack. And just like bin Laden, okay, No one talks about him being a victim or his family. No one should talk about Hamas being a victim.
May I just pick up on a point you said there? You served as defense minister for a period of time that the court intends to probe. Do you personally have something to fear? Do you fear that you may be named?
No, I don't fear anything. I am defending my own country. You know, we've got this small country called Israel that's a tower of democracy, a tower of liberty among the worst terror regimes in the world. This ICC didn't even think of accusing ISIS for criminal crimes. They said, oh, no, that's, you know, we can't do that. But Israel, a democracy with almost 2 million Arabs that enjoy full equal rights, so we're the villains. I don't buy this. You know, Jews have been under anti-Semitism for thousands of years. We're not going to put up with this. The difference is now we can defend ourselves.
Well, there are many groups, aren't there, including Amnesty International, saying that Palestinian militant organizations had committed war crimes during the Gaza war. You will know better than most the horrors of that. Don't you want those people exposed and prosecuted by the International Criminal Court, that that's going to happen now at last, that their crimes will be exposed?
You know, I almost couldn't care. I'm not depending on the world justice system, which is so perverted, so skewed, so screwed up to take care of it. We're fighting our battles to defend the lives. I've got four children that live in Israel. They're being attacked by a terror organization. I'm not waiting for the world to protect us, because the last time we tried that, it didn't work really well. We're going to defend ourselves by ourselves. And yes, we do call on the entire world to say, to call a spade and say, these folks are terrorists. These folks are the good people. There is sometimes right and wrong. And when someone tries to mix that up, I'm not buying that.
Okay, but do we not see in terms of world history, from Northern Ireland to South Africa, the world over, that it just reaches on, it goes year to year, more violence breeds more violence. Isn't having everything out in the open, drawing a line under the problems of this particular period, the only way to move forward in the hope of a lasting peace, which I'm sure you desire for you and your children?
You know, we actually tried that out. Let me tell your viewers a fact that they might not know. Israel held Gaza, and then we tried out peace. In 2005, we expelled all the Jews out of Gaza, handed Gaza back to the Palestinian Authority, took out all our soldiers to the 1967 lines and said, here, it's yours. And you know what they did? The day after, they started shooting rockets. Since then, they've shot thousands of rockets on our homes.
Well, we should
explain, though,
that what the area you're talking about, the Gaza Strip, 17 square miles, 2 million people, this is the area you're talking about, one of the most densely populated areas on the planet, and one of the most depleted as well. And a lot of people would say that you haven't made that situation any easier.
Oh, no, you're absolutely wrong. We were told, by the way, on these channels, these very channels, told that Gaza will become the Singapore of the Middle East. It'll be beautiful. And you know what? We tried it. And there was no limitation whatsoever. But these people decided that instead of building schools, instead of importing food, they imported rockets and build terror bases.
Okay,
their goal is not to build a country.
Okay.
Their goal is to annihilate the Jewish state. We're not going to let that happen.
Well, thank you very much for coming on the program and sharing your views. We've been speaking to Naftali Bennett, former Israeli Defense Minister and current Prime Minister candidate. Thank you.
Thank you very much.